Hello. Hi, guys.
You got a bag for
it? We made it. I'm at rehearsal right now, and basically we just like finished rehearsing, so there's so many people in the back. But I'm so excited to be talking with you guys and doing this all before it drops with Jeremy. It's going to be the best time ever. I don't really know how to work this thing, because this is all new and stuff. But, I love you guys, and I'm so happy that you guys are on. I'm rehearsing with the band. It's been the best time ever. So we're just going to chat with you guys for the next little while. Hello. Hello. Stop. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. You guys are talking so fast. I'm sorry. I look a bit like a shit show. I finished just, like, a lot of rehearsal, so I'm tired. And I look disgusting. I haven't gone home yet. I'm doing great, thank you. I'm very tired, but I am so excited for this. So, this song was, like, really special to me because I wrote it 2 years ago. And I wrote it by myself, and it was just, like, something that was super personal. And then Jeremy Zucker, if you guys, like, have been following me for a while, he was, like, one of the guys that got me into music, which is so cool. So he like basically like hit me up and he was like, I want to write a verse on this. He wrote it and obviously literally killed it. I'm like obsessed with it. He sounds so good. And I wouldn't want any other person to be on the song other than him. So I'm super, super pumped. Aw, you guys are so cute. Love your necklace. Thank you. It says boy. Where is he? So, Jeremy's coming soon. I promise. He's coming in, like, 2 minutes. What kind of gum are you chewing? I'm chewing mint gum. I love mint gum. Ask me some questions, because I would love to answer them before Jeremy gets on. Hi from Australia. Hello. You're so cute. You're cute. You look absolutely amazing. Thanks, guys. How do you feel that you've grown? You guys are talking so fast, and my reading skills are not that fast. How do you feel that you've grown up so much? I feel like it's been a big jump from graduating high school, like, 3 months ago, to now, like, being in my own apartment, being, like, about to go on tour all next year, and writing an album. Give me a second. Jeremy wants me to resend him the code. So, I'm going to quickly. I don't know how to. Let me know. Okay, he's sending. Okay, hello? Can you see me? Hopefully he joins now. When's the album coming? So, basically, the album is in process. I've been writing literally every single day. Last night, I finished a session at 2 in the morning, and it was crazy. So now my voice is a little tired. But now, Jeremy is here. So I'm going to accept him.
Oh, my God.
You made it.
Oh, my God. Am I here?
You're here. I have no idea.
Wow, this is crazy.
I have no idea how to work this app.
I was having so much fun watching you.
Were you watching me?
Oh my God, there's me.
Oh my God, that's so trippy. I didn't even know this was a thing. I just finished rehearsal. What are you up to?
I just finished dinner. I'm doing nothing tonight.
Sweet. I mean, he's been working on his album like crazy, so you kind of need a break.
I just finished it.
Really? Today?
Yeah, like 2 days ago.
That's amazing.
Crazy. Yeah. I gotta play it for you.
The songs that you showed me are insane. So I'm so excited for those to come out.
Same, actually. Your songs are very good, too.
Thank you.
Can't wait.
Do you guys have any questions for us on, like, this song and, I don't know, the process of it or anything? This chat goes so fast, and I can't, my vision is bad. I can't read it.
Let's see what we got.
You pick one.
What's your, yeah, y'all can't read this fast either. What's your zodiac sign?
I'm a Cancer.
I'm a Pisces.
Really? You're a Pisces?
Mm-hmm.
God, do you know your rising sign?
Yo, weirdly, I had a dream that I was at, like, the doctor, and the doctor asked me for my sign and my rising sign and my moon, and my rising sign, like, was not, was whatever I said, like, I was like, I didn't even know this was a sign, and I, like, said it. I was like, I've never heard of this sign before, but no, I could check my co-star. I feel like I'm a... Nah, I have no idea.
Well,
but I'm for sure a Pisces.
I love astrology. So interesting. And
what does a Cancer mean?
Cancers are like really intuitive and like emotional, which like isn't necessarily me on the outside. Because I'm like a Virgo on the outside, which is like a workhorse and like, but inside I'm like a Cancer, so I'm like I feel things a lot.
Well, we all know that.
Yeah, clearly we know.
Tate's sad.
I'm sad. Well, let's see what there is. Okay.
Okay. Do you like being famous?
I would never consider myself famous, so I don't know.
Yeah, same. Same, same.
Okay. So, oh, you can scroll. Okay, wait. You can scroll. What's your favorite song of each other's?
Whoa.
Oh,
I will say, you want to go first?
You go first.
Okay. I will say, since working on That Way, it's become one of my favorites. It's stuck in my head all the time. Wow. But I don't know. Call me basic, but I think You Broke Me First.
I agree.
I don't know.
Like, I agree with your opinion.
Yeah, no, that one is just gets me right in the right there.
I think my favorite song of yours, I think Not Your Fucking Friend. Is that how it, that one's so good.
Yeah, Not Your Friend.
That one's,
no way.
I love that one, and then I also love, this one's like literally an interlude. I always tell you this, it's the one that was like a minute and a half. It's called Glisten.
Mm-hmm.
I love that. I think it's so good.
That's one of my favorites too. That was on, yeah, that was a while ago. But that's one that goes like right into, does it go into All the Kids or something?
Yeah.
It goes into like Wildfire.
So.
Yeah, man. Those were the days.
Ooh.
I was watching the beginning of this and you said that my music got you into music in the first place.
Yeah.
That's crazy.
The, like, when I honestly, okay, you, this is crazy. This is like a full circle moment. When I used to dance, you, I remember you commented on one of my old dance videos. And it was,
no way.
It was me dancing to Glisten in the studio. And you commented and you were like, said something like, this is so cool or something. And I was like freaking out because I'd been like,
oh my God.
I was dying. And then it was like, shortly after that, that I was like, you know, releasing on YouTube and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
But like, I had like one playlist that like I would go back to like when I needed inspiration for songs or stuff. It was like this playlist, and like majority of the song were yours.
That's amazing and so flattering. Crazy. So this is an awesome full circle moment.
It really is. It's crazy. I think wow. It's so sick, and I'm so happy it's this song too. Because it's so, I feel like it fits so well. I mean, I usually don't love remixes. Like, the fact that, like, you take an original song and then add it to someone, I'm usually like, eh, you either like the original better. But I honestly think, our voices sound so good together.
I think it's just the beginning of the world of Tate and Jeremy.
Oh, yeah. We need to write again. That would be so.
Yeah, 100%.
Well.
What else okay. We got?
What? Do you sleep with socks on?
Ow. No. Who sleeps with socks on?
I don't either.
Who does that?
So uncomfortable.
That's psycho shit. That's like milk before cereal shit.
That, oh my god. Milk before cereal is terrifying.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Disgusting.
I agree. No socks.
Hello from Melbourne.
What else? Do you, okay. What's a movie you watched recently?
I watched Castaway for the first time the other day.
I've never seen Castaway.
It's Tom Hanks. You know what it is though, right?
No.
It's like Tom Hanks stranded on an island by himself and he starts talking to a volleyball.
Okay.
You've never heard of it?
No, I've never heard of it.
Oh, it's an American classic.
Wow.
Oh, but you're from Canada, so that makes sense. Yeah. I'm just kidding.
I watched that. I need to watch more movies.
Check it out. It's really intense, but really good. Castaway.
I literally just watched Twilight for the first time ever.
Yo, actually, I don't think I've ever seen that, and I know that I would love it because I really love like shitty but amazing. Yeah, I don't know. Like, I feel like Hunger Games is in the same category, but Hunger Games is probably better.
1000%. I mean, Twilight. So good. I loved it. Every cheesy moment, I ate that up. So good.
Have you seen the Twilight edits where I don't know if they're like it's someone overdubbing them saying different things?
See,
have you seen that?
I've seen those, and every single time that little like piano part played, I would get like flashbacks of the YouTube videos of like the parodies.
Yeah, literally. There's like one where is her name Bella, the like character, right?
Mm-hmm.
She's like it's like, I'm a fish. They're like one of the things that made her say, I gotta watch the movie.
It's because their facial expressions are so weird.
Yeah.
It makes the movie.
But Robert Pattinson is the GOAT. Edward Cullen, biggest come up.
So
any actor. Like, started off sort of as a joke in Twilight, and now he's like one of the most respected actors.
Yeah, he was insane. The whole cast, I was like, this was hired perfectly. It was so good. I can't believe I haven't
seen
it now. I also just watched Vampire Diaries for the first time.
I don't even know what that is.
I'm on a vampire kick. I'm upset.
I don't think I know any of that stuff. Just Twilight, which I haven't seen. Cedric. Okay, Robert Pattinson in Harry Potter, The Goblet of Fire.
Yeah.
Spoiler alert, he dies. Remember?
I've never seen Harry Potter.
You've never seen Harry Potter?
No, or Star Wars. I haven't seen, like, a lot of...
Okay, I'm trying to understand if this is, like, an age difference thing or if this is, like, a cultural difference thing.
This is me being just, like, I don't get into movies. Like, I just don't.
Okay.
So I'm like, I've missed out on a lot of like classics. So
we got a lot of catching up to do, for sure. Someone keeps asking what shampoo do you use?
I use a shampoo called Olaplex because...
Oh, that's really good for your hair if you color it.
Because my hair is so dead right now. I need to take care of it. And I shower like sometimes twice a day. I love showers.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
That's a lot.
I know. What kind of shampoo do you use, Jeremy?
I don't really like ever buy the same shampoo twice. Is that weird? You know?
It's weird.
Like, just because I'm getting shit at like Walgreens and I know that none of it is good. But also, I only shampoo my hair like once or twice a week. So
okay.
I feel like it doesn't really matter what I use. But I use conditioner like every day. Every other day.
Okay.
Yeah. When my hair was blonde, it was so difficult to manage. That's like a big reason why I went back to brown.
I know. Blonde is a hassle and a half.
Your hair's just dead the whole time.
I'm going to go back to brown. 1000%.
Are you blonde? Or I guess you're like light brown, dark blonde.
I'm blonde. I dyed my hair fully blonde, but now, like, my roots are growing in, so now I'm going back to brown.
Are you going to full-on dye it back or just let it grow out?
I want to go black, like, black hair. Like, I think that would...
Oh, hell yeah.
I feel like that would be, like, a move, but my mom said no, so...
You do not, I mean, all the respect to Tate's mother, but you can do what you want.
I actually might want to. I feel like that would be a look. You know what I mean?
I've been dyeing my hair black, but it's sort of hard to tell because it's already so dark.
It's really dark.
But it makes me feel like a little emo.
Yeah, it's a good look. I like the little patch, too.
Thank you.
Okay, what other songs are there? Are you Team Jacob or Team Edward?
Dude, I told you, I haven't seen it. Oh, what are you? I feel like it's got to be Team Edward, right?
I mean, I like them both. I mean, I like Jacob a lot, though. I thought he was...
What's Jacob's real name, like the actor?
Taylor Lautner.
Taylor Lautner slid into Chelsea and I's DMs.
No
Individually.
Way.
Maybe like 6 months ago. And it was, Chelsea and I were in Mexico because it was like me, Chelsea, and our manager and Quinn 92. It was like a family trip.
Okay.
And he DM'd me while we were like on a boat in Mexico. And like, we're just sending him videos of us like, yo, we love you.
Oh my God. That's insane.
Crazy moment.
I would die. Yeah. I love him. I love Taylor Lautner.
He's a good-looking dude. I wonder what he's up to these days.
Very good-looking dude. Okay. What? Every time that I, like, pick a question, I can't keep it.
Yeah, I feel that.
Okay.
Let's do some, like, music-related stuff, right?
Yeah, we should definitely do music-related stuff.
How'd you get inspired to write that way?
How'd I get inspired to write that way? So, it was based on a real experience. I was in grade 10, and I think it was a situation where there was, like, a guy who I feel like I told you this story. There was, like, a guy that, like, we were, like, friends, but there was, like, that you knew was more than friends, but because of, like, the tension, we kind of hated each other, but then again, we, like, couldn't stop talking to each other, like, all the time, and so it was, like, that feeling of, like, having a super massive crush, but just, like, knowing that you're never gonna be with this person, and it was, like, kind of heartbreaking, but then again, I was, like, still, like, I was, like, oh my God, like, obsessed with this boy. That's what inspired the song, pretty much.
Love that.
Okay, wait, let's see if there's any more. How do you come up with a melody, and how do you know if it's good or not? What's your writing process, Jeremy?
I don't, like, my process, like, changes a lot, which gets really frustrating, because I don't, sometimes I'm like, do I even know how to make music, you know?
Uh-huh, same.
But I guess, like, I try to get into the state where I'm just, like, there's no barrier in my mind to, like, what I'm singing or saying or writing down.
Yeah.
And I'm very, very inspired by, like, the music first. I very rarely am, like, have lyrics that I want to put into a song. It's sort of always, like, the music is inspiring what I'm going to write about. And a lot of times, like, it just comes out. And then afterwards, I'm like, whoa, I just wrote about this because this happened to me and I'm feeling this way. And it's, like, a really backwards, like, therapeutic thing that, but yeah, it doesn't always happen like that, and
yeah,
it's frustrating, like, when it doesn't, obviously.
I feel like the worst thing to do is, like, go into a session and think about if someone were to be listening to it and, like, criticizing it. Like, that's the worst headspace you can be in.
Yeah.
If you go into,
that's why it's so hard to, like, go into sessions, and because I guess, like, my favorite writing happens when I'm alone.
Yeah.
And it's really rare to, like, really get in that flow with another person. I think you have to be really comfortable with them, and it has to be, your minds just have to be, like, working the same way to, like, really get somewhere good. Totally. Yeah, it's just hard to like, it's hard to be personal and hard to like not think about what other people are thinking when there's someone else in the room. And if you're by yourself, you're just not thinking about what other people are thinking.
For sure.
You know?
Yeah, that's, I agree with that. I think once you get into that headspace is like the biggest writer's block. I always think in my head, if I ever get in that situation where I like think too hard about like writing a song and writing a song for putting it somewhere or putting it out, I end up thinking that every song is the same and that every single topic has been done before.
The best, you can't think of it that way.
No, you got it. The best headspace is thinking of like, because sometimes the shittiest ideas can turn into the greatest songs because you're kind of just like letting it happen naturally, which is hard to do sometimes if you're in a weird headspace.
Totally. I mean, think about how many movies are about like love.
Totally.
How many songs are about love? Like it's, I don't know. It's not so much about the topic as about like how it, yeah, how it's done. Like
yeah. You said. How they phrase it or how they write it. I mean, how many rom-coms have the exact same plot? I was noticing today, I'm like, I can literally predict every single rom-com plot. Okay.
Yeah. For better or worse, some of them are trash, but then some are so good. Have you seen 50 First Dates?
Yes. So good.
That's a good one.
So good.
I wonder if it aged well, because I haven't seen it in like 10 years.
I haven't seen it in like 5 years. A very long time. But I knew it was.
What's the song from that? There's like a. Is it Beach Boy? No, who is it? Never mind.
Never mind.
What's the? Sorry, my memory is bad.
Mine is worse. I have a horrible memory. My memory's very bad. I'm curious, are majority of your songs written about, like, your life? Or is it, do you pull from things like your friend's life, from, like, things that you observe about or watch? Or, like, because I know there's some people grab it from, like, movies or grab it from, is majority of your work or, like, let's say your upcoming album, is it about, like, your life?
Yeah, it's really, like, I'm sort of the narrator, you know, and it's either about me or I'm talking to someone. It's never really about like, oh, these people are doing this, you know?
Totally.
I don't really consider myself like a storyteller in that sense. And even on a more literal note, I'm like really bad at telling stories, like even just in person in front of people, like trying to like recount an event and like tell it with the right timing and like a punchline does not go well at all. I think that sort of carries through in like my like storytelling ability in music. So a lot of the times, like I feel like my best lyrics are conversational and like it's just stream of consciousness. Yeah. I just sort of like, yeah. So it's all very much like, this is how I'm feeling. This is how I'm thinking. Like, this is what I'm saying to you. And yeah. I really try to like write in a way that gets me excited and not, yeah. I'm not a good storyteller. That's it. What about you? I feel like your stuff is so personal.
Yeah, my stuff are like direct situations, or I'll take something like super small and I'll like blow it up into something else. Like, and I feel like if you have like one baseline point, because in my head, if I'm not picturing something, I'm like super visual. Like sometimes I'll just scroll through like pictures when I'm writing a song and just like play my piano, because if I'm not looking at anything or if I'm not picturing like a person in my head or something, I have no idea how to write a song. I have no idea where to start.
Right.
What I'm saying, the song doesn't make any sense. But then
thing's really interesting.
Totally, yeah. I'll like, if I have like things going through my brain, I could write it super fast. And when otherwise, if I don't have anything in my brain, it's literally like white noise. Like I will not think of anything at all.
Wow. Wild.
It is wild. Like I need to be able to picture things. Otherwise nothing will, like, I feel like every single lyric for me has like I can relay a picture to it. Of some
That's sort. The way it should be.
I agree. Otherwise,
visual
doesn't mean anything.
You ever think about like what someone else is picturing when they're hearing your words? Not while you're writing, obviously, because that's like a trip to think about while you're writing, but like, I don't know, it's just so wild. Like, you look at the numbers on your music, and it's really hard and creepy to imagine each one of those numbers is like someone listening to that, having an experience to that song,
and putting it into their own life. Like, it's a different people, different lives, different situations. It's so crazy. Because, and then you actually realize at the end of the day, like, everyone's lives are pretty damn similar, and everyone's thoughts are super similar. And that's why I think music, like, you know, like, situations that you would think, oh my God, no one went through this, no one could have gone through this, everyone's gone through it. Like, you know, like, it's so crazy to think that everyone has their own people that are doing the exact same thing as other people.
Yeah. I remember, like, one of the first moments I had becoming, like, I think the first artist I was a really big fan of was Black Bear.
Yeah.
And I listened to, do you know, like, his first project, Afterglow?
I probably know some of the songs on it, but.
There's a song called Hotel Andrea, I think it is. And I remember, like, one of the first times I heard it in my friend's car. And I was just hit with this wave of, like, holy shit, I had no idea that somebody else felt this way. You know?
Crazy.
And, like, there's this insane moment of connection. And I think it, like, really especially hits people that are, like younger people that are, like, really going through a time, like, a tough time or a period of transition. And it's just a trip, man. We're really lucky to,
I know, like,
be that voice.
That's one of my favorite things to do after you, like, finish, like, a piece of work. Sometimes I, like, go through my songs when I'm, like, listening to them, and I'll be like, okay, I'm this person listening to this album. And I'll, like, I always do that, and it hits you so different. Like, it literally...
That's crazy. Wait, do you do that with your own music, or while you're listening to someone else's music?
Like, after I write something, and I write it about someone, then afterwards I'll be like, okay, let's see if I'm in this person's, like, head. How would they think of this song?
Wow.
I love doing that. It's, like, my favorite. Wow.
I think of that sometimes because when I write a song and it's, like, really specifically about someone, I'm like, how are they going to react to this, you know?
I know. It's crazy. Well, oh, my God. So it's 8:59.
1 minute.
Everyone stay on this page. I'm going to end this thing, and you're going to go straight to the lyric video.